Jason, thanks so much for coming on. We have a few friends in common.
For sure.
Yeah, one of them is Questlove.
You know what? It's so interesting because he doesn't know this. I'm his friend. He's not mine.
Okay.
So basically, Questlove and Mr. Trotter here, they have this website, OK Player. Happy 25th anniversary, fellas.
Oh yeah, OK Player.
And
yeah,
what absolutely. People? What absolutely. Which was a community for people like me and all these other hip-hop heads and a specific cultural set. And they were the first platform that published me. I was a reviewer for them for a very long time.
Is that right?
I was a music reviewer for OK Player for a very, very, very
long time. No way.
Absolutely. So thank you, fellas. I appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you.
That's fantastic. And Tariq as well? You know Tariq?
You know what? 20 years ago, I sat on the stage in Penn State, and he was the featured guest for this night, and I was supposed to be his opening act. And at the time, he was going to come and going to recite his lyrics but a cappella. And he was late. And then he shows up, and I'm thinking like, oh, you know, this is one of my heroes. I'm thinking he'll be a diva. They say don't meet your heroes. And he comes in, he sits next to me, and he apologizes for being late. And then I ask him if he'd like some water, and he says, no, thank you. And I was so taken by his politeness and his respectfulness that forever and ever and ever, I will always know how to manage success and how to treat people in my everyday life. And I wanted to tell him that. I appreciate it.
It meant a lot,
yeah.
He is a gentleman.
He's a gentleman.
Another person we have in common is Queen Latifah.
The best.
I mean, that's my pal.
Better than them both.
Right? I mean, better than both. She's unbelievable, yeah.
Absolutely.
What's
absolutely.
Your connection with Latifah?
When I was a kid, reading was difficult. It wasn't something I was interested in.
Yeah.
And so the way that I sort of got around it and the way that I discovered my love for language is I would go to the store and I'd buy rap cassette tapes.
Yeah.
And I would come home and I would open them up and I would read the liner notes. And the liner notes, you know, the lyrics were all printed there. Yeah. And when you read the lyrics, you realize just how much hip-hop really is poetry. And the first cassette tape I ever bought was Queen Latifah's Black Rain. It changed my world.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Have you ever got a chance to meet...
Twice. But not really. You know, this is the story of my life, right? It's like I used to sell clothes downtown New York City. And one day, Queen Latifah walked in the store. And this is my moment, you know? And she's looking for a sweatshirt. And I can't figure out how to address her. I don't know if I'm supposed to call her Queen, which seemed a little inappropriate. If I should call her Latifah, which seemed a little inappropriate.
Yeah.
If I should call her Dana, which seemed way too inappropriate.
That's right? Actually, yeah.
And then she walked out of the store.
You're like, Queena. I have no idea what to call her, yeah.
And then years later, my life changed, and I was able to get in touch with her on FaceTime, and I got to tell her thank you.
Ah, she's the best. She doesn't care what you call her. She's just friendly and cool.
She's
and
amazing.
Smart. Yeah, yeah, she's brilliant. Congrats on all your success. Is it 13-time New York Times bestseller?
Something like that.
The latest book, There Was a Party for Langston. I have a photo here you said was the inspiration for this. Explain what was happening. Is this Maya Angelou?
This is Maya Angelou and the great Mary Baraka. The picture was taken by a brother named Chester Higgins Jr. And they're at the Schomburg Museum, the Schomburg Library here in Harlem, right uptown. And they're dancing at this party that is meant to dedicate this particular space in the library to the great Langston Hughes. And what's most interesting is underneath them, built into the floor, are the ashes of the great Langston Hughes. So they're dancing on the ashes of all of our heroes.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is wild.
Yeah, it's amazing.
How do you feel when you write these books and you get the response that you get, like, from a lot of your books are for young adults or children? Isn't it moving? Is it something you ever thought you could do? And you're like, oof.
It is. When I show up to schools or if I show up to community centers or libraries, you know, one of the things that young people always say is, man, I didn't know that a writer could look like this, right? That you could come in sneakers and jeans and t-shirt and tattoos and long hair. You could look like all of our favorite rappers. You could look like our athletes and still be a writer and be someone who uses language as a way to free themselves and free the people around them, right? Language as a way to connect us all, right? Yeah. You don't have to look a particular way or button up or put on a suit or be a professor, right? That you could be a kid from the neighborhood and express yourself in a way that that just might give somebody else the opportunity to express themselves that way. Yeah. And I, you know, and I think...
Congratulations.
Thank you, man. And I know you know this better than anybody, right? You've gone through it yourself, and you know what it's like. I think there's no greater task than to give our children a fair swing through the art of letters.
Yeah. It's fantastic. You do great work. And actually, a very cool thing you're doing tonight. Everyone in tonight's audience is going home with a copy of your book. That's what I'm talking about. Jason Reynolds, everybody! For Langston is available now. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around. That's what I'm talking about.